What's up, guys? Scott Reviews here, and there are a lot of things I can get into about DVDs and Blu-rays and making them just an overall better experience.
Removing unskippable trailers.
Now, lately, I've seen some newer discs that have come out overseas that have better packaging, loaded extras, and a booklet. Yeah, remember that criterion?
What is this?
But it's region locked. Now, before we talk about region locking and how to get around that, we need to talk about region coding. DVDs, Blu-rays have region coding. It's a digital management tool that rights holders or movie studios control which part of the world this disc can be played in.
DVD has 6 regions.
Blu-ray has 3 regions coded A, B, C. You can find out which disc you own on the back of the box and by looking on the back of your player. So why do you need to know this? Well, if you happen to live on another side of the world or travel and you buy a Blu-ray or if you buy a DVD and you happen to come to the United States and decide to play it on your United States player and it doesn't work, well, you're gonna have a bad time. So you spend that money, what gives? Well, some movies have multiple rights holders across the world and don't like competition, and region locking is basically their way of preventing you from buying the disc and using it from outside that part of the world. Oftentimes I run into this, typically because the rights holders give a license to a third-party distributor. Say like a small boutique label like Arrow, Second Sight, Scream, Criterion, what have you, and oftentimes the rights holders want that disc to be region locked. Not so much the distributor. And movie collectors will find ways around this region locking, but the thing that I've noticed is that my family, whenever I put on, say, Christmas or any sort of like list of wants, they're always confused. Why do you want the German version of this particular movie?
And they're mostly frightened from ordering anything from Amazon UK.
And then also your average consumer is probably going to look at this and go, what are these ugly logos on the box? Like, look at them. They're horrifying. Now, when it comes to 4K UHD, go nuts, because it is region free. There is no region locking on any 4K UHD discs, and that's what makes it super nice. But rights holders are still fighting it. Jerks. For example, Second Sight is releasing what appears to be the definitive edition of Dawn of the Dead in 4K UHD and Blu-ray, dethroning the Anchor Bay 4-disc DVD Ultimate Edition. While the 4K is region-free, the extras on that Blu-ray disc is region-locked. The extras disc. Oh, come on! Now, also bear in mind that I'm creating this rant video while I do have region-free players. And I'll kind of get into why I'm making this video.
So ways to get around it, some are available pre-modded through online sellers, like this one here. You can plug in, put in a code on the player while it's off, turn it on, and boom, it's playing that region's Blu-ray. And it will stay on that region until you change it again,
which can get very annoying if you forgot about it.
Or ones like this, where it's out of the box, you plug in a code in the menu and get that region code menu.
And also, you have to make sure that you set it back to that region, and just really annoying. I would rather just have a player that just played all the discs and be done with it. Now, some Panasonic Region A players can also play Region B Blu-rays by just tricking the player into playing it by pressing the home and menu button over and over and over again until you get a success. For DVDs, it's also super confusing, at least for some of my DVD players, also my Blu-ray players. You could set it, the DVD region, to 0, and it will just play every single disc that you throw at it.
If you're on a cheaper budget, there's free software like MakeMKV that you can back up those video files onto an external hard drive, and then you just plug it into an Xbox or whatever, and look, there's your region-locked movie. Just missing the menu, and there's some many other ways to achieve a region-free backup too with other software. But for me, because I mostly import only region B locked Blu-rays and I have several other players, I'm currently only using my region-free players as region B only. Blu-ray.com is a good resource to find out if an import Blu-ray you own is region locked.
I think for consumers, competition really benefits us. If a company is not going to release a movie, or if they're just going to throw whatever master they have on there while another territory decides they're going to do a 4K master, then I think that consumers should be able to choose which version they would actually want.
and it would probably get us better releases. So guys, that's it for this video. If you liked it, please like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.